Hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to my playlist where I'm covering HTML5 crash course. It is basically for the beginners who started the web development and wanted to understand all different tags in HTML5 we are using for designing any web page, web layout, how we integrate CSS, how to add a JavaScript for a particular page, what all new things have been added in HTML5. So I'm not covering basic HTML tags, I'm just covering what is new in our HTML5, what all things has been added, and we will just go one by one for particular element, particular tag, particular attribute, what all new formatting tags we have added, how to design a table and ordered list, unordered list, how to create HTML layout with header, footer and body and navbar, styling the HTML5 different tags using CSS. So we will see how you can add a styling using inline styles or using putting the CSS in a particular .css file. Okay, and we will talk about basic layout, how to design a basic layout with header footer. Then basic form validation. So whenever we talk about any website, most of the website has the login form, registration form, where you have to enter user information and where we will be doing a form validations and all these things. So all these things start from the basic, how we do the validations, how we design the page. Then we will see how we can create a layout using a float property. We will just try to design a layout. And then we will see how we can add a CSS in a particular page. Okay, so I will be using this Scrimba platform. What it does is it will give you the live output on this particular window. So whatever you are doing here, you will be able to capture it. Okay, so HTML5 is the latest versions and it has a lot of latest features added. These are the features I'm going to talk about in a different modules and different sections. Like we have a new semantics tag, which is header, footer, navbar, article sections, audio and video tag. New form controls has been added, like the progress bar, etc. Okay, and we can do the form validations in the HTML5. The SVG, it has a good support for the vector-based drawings. Canvas for the 2D drawings we have. CSS3, new selectors and property. Detect the physical location. So it says HTML5 geolocation APIs. Web storage, we'll talk about how you can deal with the local storage, cookie storage or the session storage. Okay, then we have a drag and drop. So these are the different kind of events. If you wanted to drag and drop a particular element, then this is also provided. So overall, if you talk about what are the new tags which has been added in HTML5, so you will see the article, section, details, summary, progress, navbar, header, footer, picture. All these tags are actually new. So I mean, we use these tags in our daily life in different applications. So like this is a particular heading, article tag, which has been added. Similarly, we have a section tag. We can create a particular sections. This is also a new HTML5 tag. Just indent it, and here we can just keep seeing the output. Sidebar, a side is the sidebar of a container. The content inside a side is related to the content around. So we can also use this particular tag. So after closing of the section, so I'm just putting these tags random for now. You can see this is like a left sidebar you wanted to have, then you can use this particular tag. Then detail tag, I mean, if you wanted to just show and hide the detail of particular DOM node, right? So if you just expand it, you can see this magic happening. So that is covered in the detail tag, and you can see a lot of other tags are the time. You wanted to show the time, command, fig caption. So for a particular picture, for HTML5 picture tag is used to show either a high or low resolution image. So this is something new added. So we'll just talk about these in the further sections also. What is this is how to show the image on the HTML5, right? So what it is taking the picture, okay, and source and the image, and all these are attributes. So what is the attribute, what is the element, you need to understand. All these are tags, head, HTML, body, h1, article, section, all these are HTML tags. And what you see the attributes here, attributes are like this. So image is a tag and we have source. These attributes will come in the key value pair, source and source value. Alternate text, if image is not available, then this will be shown, right? Similarly, we have a header, like we wanted to put a header for a particular section, then we can use this particular tag. What it is doing is Inside a section, it is creating header for a particular tag. Then we have a footer. All these new tags have been added in the HTML5. Okay, in HTML5, the major change which we can see, the visible change which happened, is about the new attributes which has been added. Before that, what is the attribute? So all these are tags. When we just specify, okay, anchor tag I'm talking about, and here I'm not giving reference, because if you already have written HTML, then you already know what anchor tag does. It actually create a link for your page. So here you just provide a hello.html and it will be able to create a link. So this href is a property, href is an attribute, and it is holding the value. So it is coming as a key value pair. So what all new attributes has been added in HTML5, if we just look at it. So in the script tag, you might have seen that when the page is published on the browser, what it does is it actually try to render first HTML DOM. It creates HTML DOM, then it integrated with the styles, and then finally it starts doing a DOM manipulation by adding a JavaScript. So you can do async. So what it will do is it will defer the execution of JavaScript, defer the loading of JavaScript for a particular page. So async attribute ID is used in external JavaScript to load external JavaScript asynchronously. So I mean, it will not block anything, it will be loaded in the background. Similarly, we see one new attribute which has been added. So I will just call it as a new attribute in HTML5. So I will be extending it a little bit more. So the first new attribute which we will talk about is content editable. So now you can put a content editable. This paragraph is editable, so you can put something here, right? Next is the data attribute. Now we can define the data attribute in the HTML DOM nodes, date time attribute and all. Now another thing is the download. Sometimes we wanted to give a download link for any particular resource, PDF and all, then you can just click on it. What it will do, it will trigger a download on your page. Okay, draggable, drag and drop is something new which has been added in the HTML5, and what it does is it allows you to drag your, so you can see the draggable attribute which is added. So you can, draggable means you can drag this. You can see I'm able to drag it. The another one I will not be able to drag it. Hidden attribute, to hide a particular element from the user, then you can use the hidden attribute. And then another important is, you might have seen the input or select in the HTML form in earlier versions. I'm just talking about these snippets because that should cover a lot of things. Now you can see I can have a data source. So this is a data source. You can bind input text field with a list. List, what the list is? List is pointing to this list one ID, and this is the data options which need to be shown. So it looks like something like this. Okay, so input text field with select. We sometimes write a custom, but this is available native to HTML5. Okay, and we have this detail attribute which we have already seen. Detail attribute is here, we have seen, like you can expand and hide a particular information for until unless user hits it. Okay, similarly, HTML5 has removed few attributes like background, background color, align, that we will, that can be looked at later. Okay. So what is HTML5? Before, HTML5 used to have HTML, XHTML and all these things. So HTML5 is more semantics than HTML4. HTML5 includes semantics element like header, name, article, section, figure, footer, all these which we just talked about, header, footer, section, articles. And it gives a good structure to all the elements. And on the top, you have to define the doc type HTML. You don't need to define a DTD definition, which we were doing earlier. And in the HTML5, there is a new property language, which is a locale for your page, to tell the browser, okay, the locale for this particular page is English. Okay, so HTML5 has a compatibility with other browsers also. I mean, it is just providing the polyfills so that other browsers can also be compatible with that. So let's get started. In this particular module, we will be talking about these two elements, module 0 and 1. We will talk about different tags, different formatting syntax, how to style these different tags using CSS, how to create a layout, how to write a basic HTML form, like you wanted to create a sign up form, registration form, then you will be just writing HTML form, submitting the form and all. I will be talking about a basic layout, like different kind of layout which is having header, footer, some kind of a nav links, and when you click on to the links, content is getting changed. Okay, this is the module 0. We will be most probably covering the 10 videos. Then we will talk about module 2. In the module 2, we will cover only the advanced things, which is about HTML5, APIs, local storage, WebSocket, web workers, all the this canvas designs, canvas drawing, all the advanced things in HTML5. Okay, thanks everyone.